Elisaim. I already did a taste test on a, shall we say, sideline of my chili breeding program, the Cariolochia Screepa Strain A, which is an accidental backcross, I have to admit. And in the video where I did the taste test, I was rather disappointed and switched around the plans for my breeding program and decided to mostly abandon this breeding line, hence sideline. It went nowhere, I guess. But I did have some other plans of this line, not many, but a few, and they had quite a bit of trouble this year due to logistical troubles. You know, 2020, difficult year, even for chili peppers in some aspects, and they dried out a few times. They produced a bunch of flowers, but always when they were ready to produce fruits, there were always some troubles and they didn't receive enough water, and in the end they finally dried out a few weeks ago, I guess. And but one of them did manage to pop out some little fruits as a last ditch, a dying effort, you could say. And I think I owe it to this chili peppers, which were so valiant to produce some fruits in the end, that I should at least taste them. Maybe they are amazing in heat and taste, and I will stick to this breeding line, but I don't think, but well, we shall see. Well, the fruits are quite similar to the ones that I already checked in the last taste test video of the Cariolochia Screepa Strain A. They have a almost like a little tail, but not really, which is from their Reaper and perhaps Trinidad Scorpion Moruga Red ancestry. This one, for example, almost the slightest of a little stub at the end. But yeah, and the plants were also not very noticeable. No special features, just many fruits per node, which is a feature that I like, and they were rather bushy, not very bushy, but growing to a big height. And yeah, they are already shriveled up a bit, those fruits. I think I will try this one. Maybe the plant died before the fruit was completely ripened. It's a little bit a little bit lighter on one end, and coloration is stronger on this end. Yeah, but I think, yeah, I will try this one. This one here. I have to admit, I did not prepare my gastrointestinal tract for a super hot chili pepper by eating lots of oats and fatty milk, for example. But I don't think this will be all that necessary. I guess I deserve a little bit of pain. A bit more than necessary. Let's see. Oh my. Took a while for any heat to be detectable. There is heat. Now it starts to sting. It's building up, but no, not. I guess it's more habanero level of heat. The taste is, I guess, indistinguishable from my regular Caryolochia scorpion strain D, for example. So, no improvement in heat or taste, which was the very reason why I crossed in at the Carolina Reaper. Well, since the plant produced these fruits when it was basically dying, and normally stress increases the heat levels, that's disappointing. So I guess I am correct in abandoning this breeding line and focusing on different breeding lines, and this will be explained in another video that's coming up, my future breeding plans, and I think I'm onto something now. But yeah, I fulfilled my duty. The plant produced the fruits. I tasted them. Sorry, they're not very good, and I can discard this breeding line. I will save the seeds anyway, but I'm pretty sure that I won't be using them in the future.